Yo, what is up, everyone? My name is Diamond. We're here to talk about unusual options activity. All right, let's kick it off with the disclaimer. Disclaimer, this video is for educational purposes only. The statements made in this programming are solely the opinion of a show and are not a specific inducement to make an investment. One must perform their own due diligence and realize that all investments carry risk. There's no guarantee of profit. All right, everyone, first one I want to bring up is Root. Now, this is another Reddit short squeeze, whatever you want to call it, name here. Now, you know, this is purely a spec. This is purely a speculative play here. You know, there was a lot of option contracts traded here. 20,000 of these June 12 and a half strike calls. There was even some calls trading here of these June 35 strike calls. Now, in July, there was some nice volume here. They're buying these July 15 strike calls. Now, I jumped into these July 15 strike calls. And, you know, one thing I want to mention here is about implied volatility. Now, you know, if you catch these early, you know, before the implied volatility spikes, I think this morning the implied volatility for these options, you know, was at about 100%. Now it's at 143% because all these people start coming in and start buying up these calls. If people start buying more calls, that increases, there's obviously more demand for the calls, which increases the implied volatility. So most of the move on, you know, these sort of, you know, short squeeze stocks where, you know, people start coming in and, you know, aggressively buying up these calls, the most of the good move is when you catch it early, you know, when it's a lower implied volatility and you can, you know, ride the stock as it's rising, as people are buying a crap ton of calls, and you can make money on the implied volatility going up here, because just for this option contract right here, you gain $2 for every percent move up in the implied volatility. So say the implied volatility was at about 100% this morning, which I think that's what it was at. You know, now it's at 143%. So 43% it moved times $2 for every percent increase. That's about an $80 increase per contract when this option was probably, you know, I don't know how much it was this morning, but, you know, on right now it's $144. You know, you could have increased, if it increased from 100 to 143% implied volatility, $80. That's almost half the option price right there. So, you know, that it also works on the way down as well. You know, when this stock starts, you know, if it does start rolling over and starts tanking, the implied volatility in theory will come down and you will lose $2 for every percent decrease in the implied volatility. So that's why, in my opinion, it's really prudent to take your profits off the table. And, you know, these stocks that are running, you know, 15, you know, to 30% in one single day, you know, that just does not happen rarely at all. And one thing I will caution, you know, I don't want to spend too much time talking about this one. You know, this thing is up a lot after hours. It's up $2 after hours. It closed at about $11.30. And right now it's at about $13.24 after hours. So I will caution everybody, this thing is probably going to be up a lot in the morning. So, you know, I don't know if this is a trade that, you know, some of you are going to want to put on. You know, you have to make that decision on your own. Always remember, this is for educational purposes only. I'm, you know, here telling, you know, what I've learned and, you know, what I'm doing. And, you know, hopefully everyone can learn from it. So, you know, everyone watching this has to, you know, decide their risk tolerance and, you know, decide, you know, if they're going to, you know, get into this trade tomorrow if it's up a lot. Next one I want to bring up is, here, I'll just bring up the chart real quick. I don't want to spend too much time, but this thing is probably one of the worst looking charts in the market. You know, it's done really nothing but, you know, consistently go down. So I would see, you know, why there's a 70% short interest in this one. I don't think I mentioned that, but, you know, if you're, you know, jumping in and, you know, shorting stocks with this high of a short interest, you know, you are going to get burned in this market, in my opinion. So next one I want to bring up is Roblox. Sorry about that. Next one I want to bring up is Roblox. Now, this is a really, really good company here. They reported earnings on May 10th, and the stock has done nothing but go up since then. Now, this thing has had, you know, a nice pullback here from this 103 level down to this 91 level. You know, people were coming in, you know, buying these really short-term option contracts here. You know, that really does not interest me a whole lot. You know, for a stock like this, for a stock like Root, you know, I wouldn't mind jumping into a super short-term option like that because it's kind of a hit or miss. But, you know, this one, you know, there was some nice buying also in these July calls here. They were coming in buying these July 120 strike calls. Now, if you've been watching this channel for any length of time, you know that I like to usually buy an at-the-money call and sell an out-of-the-money call. So what I did here is I bought the 95 strike call and I sold the 115 strike call. So I paid about $4.50 for something that can go to $20 if this stock is through 115 on expiration. So, you know, we just took a look at the chart here. You know, we'll come down to these time of sales here. You know, check this out. There was some nice volume here, some nice orders, you know, some big traders coming in here and placing some big bets. You know, these, you know, 1800 at $173 each. You know, you could do the math on that. That's pretty, that's a good amount of money to put down on these contracts that expire July 16th. So it's only about six weeks for this trade to work out here. And mind you, they're buying the 120 call when the stock is at 91. So they need the stock to be through $120 on expiration for this trade to be worth anything. Obviously, you know, if the stock moves up a lot tomorrow, they're going to have a profit in the option and they could get rid of it. But, you know, in theory, that is what they're betting. It's going to be above 120 by July 16th. So, that is it. Yeah, we checked out the chart already. So that's it for this video. Thanks to everyone who's been subscribing. You know, I really appreciate the subscribing. I appreciate all the comments. You know, I always say to myself, if I had, you know, a channel like this, you know, somebody I could, you know, ask questions to, you know, when I first started doing this, you know, it would be, you know, amazing, and I'd be super grateful for it. So, you know, I hope you guys are definitely learning something. And, you know, feel free to leave a comment down below if you got any questions. I'm here to teach, you know, I'm here to learn, you know, this is a community, and, you know, hopefully, you know, we're all here to learn and, you know, prosper together in the stock market. So, thanks for everyone who's been subscribing, I really appreciate it. Make sure to keep the subscribing up, and leave a like if you enjoyed the content, and we'll see you next time.